Hey y'all, on the next episode of DevOps Lab, we've got a very special guest. Dan Helm's gonna be with us with his ukulele, and he's gonna be showing us some cool integrations between GitHub and Azure Boards. So if DevOps is your thing, y'all don't wanna miss this one. See you on the next episode. Welcome to the DevOps Lab. Man, I am super excited today because we have a very special guest. Dan Helm is with us, and today he's going to be talking to us about GitHub integration with Azure Boards. Welcome to the show, Dan. How's it going, dude? Great to see you.
Good. Nice to see you, Abel. It's been a while. I'm glad to be back on the show.
Yeah. So how are things going? We're talking about GitHub integration, right?
Yeah. So we're talking about GitHub integration specifically with Azure Boards.
Okay.
And so I think just to kind of set context, we've been seeing things kind of across, Azure DevOps and Azure Boards about a couple different things. We're seeing that more and more customers out there are coming up with what we call like a hybrid scenario. For repos, where they're kind of like docs in Azure or docs in Office, where they have a repo, people are partying on it for issues in the community, but they also have a set of work that's kind of off to the side that's mostly private, where they're kind of managing and setting up for features and stories for new things that are coming up. Sure. And so we're seeing that scenario. And then we're also seeing the other scenario where more and more people want to like stick their code inside of GitHub repos and yet still work inside of boards, where our developers and our customers, they're out there using GitHub. They love GitHub, and they're trying to bring that kind of same experience into the workplace. So we're seeing more customers say, hey, I really like to like have 5 or 6 or 10 or 20 of our repos inside of GitHub while we kind of manage some of our other enterprise-y stuff inside of GitHub repos. So there's a couple scenarios there where we need to kind of build some nice integration between the two so they can put their repos inside of GitHub and yet still kind of manage more of that complex planning work inside of GitHub, Azure Boards.
So I know like I can kind of like track my work a little bit using GitHub Issues. Would it make sense for me to use this integration into Azure Boards if I wanted some more like complex work item tracking type stuff, right? I'm a pure Scrum dude, right? So I want to run my team in a pure Scrum like manner. And Issues, I can kind of sort of do it, but I don't think it was really designed to be like a pure, agile type of tool, right?
Yeah, agreed. So I think, when we look at GitHub and we look at Issues, and I think, being inside of kind of that GitHub team, they've kind of discovered that once you kind of get to a team of like 8 to 10 people, Issues starts to fall down and it gets hard to manage your projects accordingly. So you have to use some sort of subsequent tool to kind of manage that more complex type stuff. And so that's where a tool like Azure Boards comes in, where you can put in, high level epics and features and break things down and do the Scrum stuff or do the Agile stuff. Or even if you're old school, you can do kind of the more waterfall stuff. And so that's all good. But what we wanted to do is open it up. So if customers wanted to put those repos inside of GitHub and they want to plan inside of Azure, Azure Boards, we need to have some sort of integration in there to be able to do those. And so we've kind of opened up several different scenarios that we can talk about on what you can and you can't do.
I would love to hear about this.
Excellent. So let's talk about like the three main scenarios that we have. So I guess we would start with inside of Azure Boards, we basically built an integration that the product group supports over the last about a year and a half to 2 years ago. And this kind of gives you like the basic stuff. So if you're an organization who just wants to put repos inside of GitHub, you want to manage your stuff in boards, we have that kind of traceability between the two, right? So it'll allow you to link your commits to a work item. It'll allow you to link your pull request to a work item. It'll allow you to link even issues to another work item. So if you could like reference them. And so that's kind of like the base scenario that's available there. There's other scenarios that come up though that you found across teams to do a little bit more. So a good example would be if I'm a team and I'm managing all my work inside of Azure Boards, and I have my code inside of GitHub, I don't want to have to bounce back and forth all the time, right? It'd be nice that if a pull request is created inside of Azure, inside of GitHub, that I'd see that that GitHub pull request just pop up in my Azure board, so my team can go ahead and do the review and approve that pull request, so it can go ahead and merge. Otherwise, I'd have to bounce between the two all the time. And so, if I'm working all my stuff in boards, I want that stuff just to show up. And then the final scenario is again, if we're part of that hybrid solution where I'm doing a bunch of work, where the community is driving like feature requests and giving input on our repo, yet I'm still managing a bunch of work that's kind of hidden with the team only in boards. Mm-hmm. Those issues that get created, I don't want to have to again go between the two and manage them both. It'd be nice if an issue gets created inside of GitHub, what automatically just shows up on my board as well. And so we basically kind of opened up those last two scenarios using actions, mm-hmm. using a GitHub action. And so the first one is supported basically as a Microsoft tool. The other two are actually what I created and been working with a bunch of folks in the community and folks across Microsoft to kind of enable it and enrich it over time.
So that sounds really, really exciting to me because I love the power and flexibility that you get with Azure Boards. And if I can get this deep type of integration that you're talking about, I kind of get the best of both worlds, right?
Yeah, exactly. So if you don't mind, let's just jump into it. I'll kind of walk through kind of what that looks like for all three of those scenarios.
Cool. Love to see it. A little
demo kind of setup that we can go through here. So the first thing to note is if I come into the marketplace, I'm going to have to go in and obviously type in Azure Boards. And you're going to see all the different types of basically what's kind of supported. So you can see the product group supported Azure Boards app and GitHub. And this kind of explains how to set it all up and kind of do all that, which we won't go through here, but it's kind of that first scenario that we talked about that mm-hmm. allows you to kind of do the deep linking between GitHub stuff and Azure Boards. And then there's also, you'll notice here too, is we have a couple, let's try that again. We have a couple actions that kind of do those other two scenarios that we talked about. So we have the GitHub issues to Azure DevOps and we have pull requests to Azure Boards. And so this basically is just an action that we've built where anytime an issue is created, it'll go ahead and then run that action and sync that issue in with Azure Boards itself. And then same thing with the pull request. Cool. Just a little an idea just for kind of like setup. It's pretty straightforward, right? It's just basically you have in the action, you define that anytime an issue is opened or edited or closed or reopened, et cetera, these things it'll go ahead and trigger. And then in here, you just define kind of the different things that are inside of Azure Boards that you want to go ahead and set it up for. So mm-hmm. In here, it requires like an Azure DevOps personal access token. What's the organization name? What's the project name? You also can put in optionally the area path and iteration path. If you have a specific area path you want these to send to or a specific iteration path. And then same thing with the work item type. So some groups will go ahead and create a custom work item type, which I'll show here briefly, where it's like a GitHub issue. That's what I want to come over. Other ones, it's use a user story. Like it's just work, right? So you can kind of pick and choose what you want. And then you can also pick the states and when it's active and new, et cetera. So there's some settings in here that you would go ahead and set to make this all kind of wire up and work.
Cool. Looks cool.
Right. Yeah. So let me kind of step through kind of through the workflow here, right? All right. So let's go ahead and take a look at like how this would potentially work. If we take a look at this, so for an example here, if I'm inside of Azure DevOps and I go ahead and create a work item. So you can see here, I have a work item for our demo and I'm going to go ahead and create some code, commit that code and watch things kind of link up. So you can see here, I'm on 5399. If I come inside of an example here for, Visual Studio Code. Here I have basically the change I'm creating for the demo. Here I have a branch. So I'm going to go ahead and now commit this change. It's just a simple change. This AB pound 5399, I would think. Double check. Yeah, so it's 5399 is the work item.
Okay.
And so we're going to go ahead and then and say, let's go ahead and now commit that change. And let's go ahead and push that change. Once that change is pushed, you will then see that it'll go to automatically provide the link back Ooh. To that particular commit.
So what triggered that was your commit comment, the AB pound and the work item number?
That's right. So there's a bot that kind of works in the background here. If we go back and take a look at my project. And you can see here, I had the pull request. There's a bot that kind of runs in the background mm-hmm. that looks for if anything, there's an AB pound 5399 in this case, mm-hmm. Look for AB pound and it says, okay, you must be trying to reference something in Azure Boards. Let's go ahead and try to reference that. Let's go and try to wire things up basically inside of Azure Boards and look for that work item 5399.
Cool.
So if I go ahead now and then create the pull request, mm-hmm. you'll go ahead and then automatically see that there's now the pull request automatically shows up inside of Azure Boards as well.
Nice.
And I'm guessing, go ahead, Abel.
This is all fascinating. So I'm guessing these are deep links, right? I can click on it and it's like, takes me all the way back into GitHub and I can see the changes.
Yeah. Yeah. So for example, if I wanted to go ahead and work on this specifically. So let's say if I close this out, the one that I was just working on and I want to go look at it, mm-hmm. it basically takes me right into that actual particular pull request.
Nice. You get that deep linking going. Cool.
Exactly. So now if we want to now, so that's kind of like that first scenario, right? Where we're just providing that kind of like transparency between what's being worked on and kind of doing that kind of linking up between my code and my actual work. Now we can kind of get into the more specifics where we talk about those actions. So I have the action installed for both pull requests and I have it installed for issues on this particular repo. And if I take a look at my basically GitHub pull requests, you can see now that the pull request actually showed up as something for me to go do. Oh. So here is basically a new work item that was created. It's a pull request work item. And if you can imagine that if I'm a team of engineers and we're all kind of working in Azure Boards, this would show up on my list to go do. And it looks like, oh no, I need to go approve this pull request that Dan created or whatever it might be. So the team has like actionable work rather than going over into GitHub to kind of see when the pull request is there or if it's there or wait for emails or that kind of thing.
I really love this, Dan. This is fantastic. Cause like pull requests are freaking amazing, right? But if I'm on a team, the thing that I hate the most is when pull requests happen, notifications go out through email with GitHub, and sometimes I see it, a lot of times I don't. And next thing you know, we've got our pull requests stacking up and dev work comes to a grinding halt, right? So this takes care of it, because then every time I create a pull request, a work item dropped on my board, I can see it, my team can see it, we can jump on it and start doing our work.
That's right. That's right. And so to make it even more interesting, if mm-hmm. I go ahead now and so let's say I resolve that work, mm-hmm. I have a pull request here now that needs to be approved. So I'm going to go in there and get it, go ahead and basically I'm going to go ahead and assume that it got approved and we went through an approval process. We're going to go ahead and squash and merge it. Mm-hmm. If we watch nice and carefully here and now because the action, so you can see here what was updated, but then you can see the action happen where the action then gets fired off. It runs in the background. Sometimes it takes a minute or two, but you'll see the actual work item automatically be completed like you just saw right there. Wow. So the pull request got completed and now it basically runs from one, basically runs to the close column. I do still have to manually close out the work here because GitHub didn't create this issue. This issue was created in Azure Board, so I'd have to manually go ahead and close that out.
Gotcha, cool.
And so that's kind of that scenario where I have my code inside of GitHub. It's mostly private and our teams are kind of working on it and getting it done. If we want to then get a little bit more interesting, let's say we're talking about that hybrid scenario where mm-hmm. I'm inside of GitHub, inside my repo, and I have people basically sending feedback and sending issues and kind of doing those kinds of things out in the community. Mm-hmm. I want that same issue to show up on my my Azure board. Mm-hmm. So here I'm going to do a demo issue for Able, and I'm going to go ahead and submit the issue. And again, if we'll watch this real quick, in the background, that issue then kicks off mm-hmm. and begins to get started and run that action code that go ahead and then that will link up this issue with the Azure Boards. So we just kind of give it a second to kind of run through. Sure. I wish it was instant, but it's not. And so here now, if I go ahead and take a look at like my GitHub issues, you'll see that I should have a new issue that just showed up, a demo issue for Able, where now I can kind of move it over here and start working on that as well. Right. And if I close it inside of GitHub, it'll automatically close it inside of Azure Boards. So this allows me to kind of throw all my work in one place, mm-hmm. do all that work in one place, whether it's a GitHub issue or not, and allows me to kind of, instead of kind of bouncing between the two. So So yeah, so we think it helps. We're hoping that it helps some customers. We've had quite a few people kind of check it out and use it. And we have some internal customers using it as well inside of Microsoft. Mm-hmm. So, but we think there's some value there, and we're hoping to kind of get some more feedback and stuff for folks to the point where if it makes sense, we can actually make it as part of the actual Azure Boards app and, rather than having it be in separate actions.
Gotcha. Okay. So that is super cool. This integration is super cool. I was going to ask you, like, why you guys made it into actions, but that kind of makes sense.
Yeah. I think the main reason we didn't build it inside of the product is we just weren't sure how many people were going to use it and how useful it was.
Yeah.
We weren't necessarily convinced that people were going to want to do both, right? And so we decided, like, okay, well, it's a lot cheaper to go ahead and create an action that I can go do it on my spare time. Mm-hmm. And build it out and see how people use it and adopt it. And if it becomes something where people really want to use it, we can go ahead and start considering sticking it into the actual product.
Wow, man, that is super, super cool, Dan, because it is so important to be able to track your work that needs to be done in your project. And with this integration between GitHub and Azure Boards, it doesn't matter how complex your workout and tracking needs are, you're totally covered without losing any bit of fidelity. And that right there makes me ridiculously happy.
Right on. So,
if people want more information about this, I guess we'll look at the links down below.
The links down below. But frankly, you just kind of go inside the marketplace and type in Azure Boards, mm-hmm. And you can see a links to all like I said, the product group supported app that's in there, and mm-hmm. then also the two actions that I've created, and it looks like there's another action in there that does some other stuff as well. So you could certainly depending on your scenario, you could use all of these, or you could use, just one or two of these.
That's freaking fantastic, Dan. Thank you so much. This is super, super neat. Viewers, go check this out. Give us your feedback. Let us know how you feel about it. And yeah, we need the feedback always. And also, see you next time on the DevOps Lab.